Hello and welcome to the Authority of Love. I'm Greg Williams, your host, and today, we're joined again by David Walls, the Executive Director of the Family Foundation, for another Family Foundation Friday. Want to say, first of all, David, thanks for joining us again.
Happy Friday to you, Greg.
Thank you, brother. The other thing I want to say is this. Thank you for those who are watching. I tend to continue to see people watching these and responding to these in some way or another, and we're thankful for that because we want to know that our prayer is simply that we help get the word out and it accomplishes what the Lord wants to have done, not only in our lives and your lives as listeners, but in our state and the nation and every place that we can see the influence of the Lord and His Holy Spirit. So we thank you for all of that. David, we got a few things to update, a couple of things. We've got a lot of victories this week to talk about. The battle is still raging, so we're going to talk about that. Remember, you can catch these at KentuckyFamily.org. Go there and you'll find, and you'll hear more about that later on, but you can find the videos and podcasts. You can also find them on loveandlordship.com. And so we appreciate you doing that. Again, give us your feedback, agree or disagree. We'd love to engage with you. So, David, with that said, I know there's a great update. We talked a little bit about last week with North Carolina, and there's some other things tied to that, with something that the Family Foundation is a part of. Share with our listeners what all that is.
Yeah, you know, we thankful. I think we've asked folks, and I know as our team, we've asked our supporters to be praying for North Carolina. They had passed a version of the Help Not Harm law to protect children against gender transitions, and but they had to overcome their governor's veto. Yeah, yeah. And they have, I think, a requirement for a two-thirds override. So there was some tension about whether they were going to be able to gather and have the votes to do that. But last week, they voted to override Governor Cooper in North Carolina. They overrode him on the Help Not Harm Act and a couple other bills as well. They had not passed a Save Women Sports law, so they overrode his veto of that, a parental rights bill as well. Why is that important? Why are we talking about North Carolina? Well, we just, as a movement of family policy councils, wanted to, it's an important milestone. North Carolina was the 20th state in just 3 years, Greg, in just 3 years.
That's significant in legislatures, right?
Yeah, yeah. Have passed a version of what's known as the Help Not Harm law that completely bans gender transitions, whether that be puberty blockers, cross-sex hormones, or the surgeries. And really, this was a movement that started in Arkansas 3 years ago. Our National Ally Family Policy Alliance really developed the first model bill on this. Mm-hmm. And from Arkansas, it's spread like wildfire. And so we're just, you know, wanting to take a moment as a movement of state family policy council organizations and really just thank the Lord for what has happened in a very short period of time, and really to recommit to one another and as a movement, caring about kids in the entire nation, to see this continue to sweep across the nation. My hope and prayer, and I know yours, Greg, too, is that we will very soon look back at these horrific procedures that were being done, so-called medical interventions that were being done on children, and say, no more. In fact, how in the world did we ever allow this to happen? And so I just want to pause and be thankful to the Lord for that and for all the states and all the work that's gone on. If folks go to our website at KentuckyFamily.org, there's a little 2-minute video that kind of highlights some of the state battles that have happened, particularly this year, including in Kentucky, and recognizes all the 20 states. Every now and then, it's important to just take a pause, reassess what, you know, what's been accomplished. And as we look back over 3 years, there's just a lot to be thankful for.
God did that in the Bible often.
Yes.
Yes, often. Don't forget. Remember. Right. And David, I know you're featured on that video along with, and we talked about North Carolina, but Louisiana is featured because those were the three states that had governors that stood in the way of that.
Yeah.
And then were clearly overridden by the legislatures, which was a powerful move.
Yeah, I was able to join a couple of our brothers that lead family policy council movements in other states in North Carolina and Louisiana, as well as with Craig DeRoche, who leads Family Policy Alliance at the national level, and did a podcast. And we were specifically just talking about highlighting the work that had to be done in a number of states where they had to override governor's vetoes. Look, it's not it's not an easy thing to do for a legislature to override a governor's veto. They happen pretty rarely.
It's designed not to be easy, right?
Right.
You gotta give checks and balances.
You know,
that's one of them.
As folks remember, we had to go through that process here in Kentucky earlier this year when our governor, Governor Beshear, vetoed SB 150, and then subsequent to that, Louisiana passed a bill and had to override their governor, and then as we said, North Carolina just did. So just, you know, in highlighting that, we want to give a lot of thanks to the courage of legislators, of the legislative bodies across this nation who were, in some cases, had to go toe-to-toe with the top executive official in their state to do the right thing. And so we're thankful for that progress that's been made.
Yeah, and I think we know we've got an election coming up, and I've said this several times. We want to make sure that people are informed about who they're actually, what they're actually voting for.
Yeah.
If you want transgender dysphoria to be celebrated and kids to be mutilated, literally, that's what's happening. If you want that, understand that Governor Beshear is your man. If you want abortion to be legal on almost any time, he is your man. If not, then you need to look and find someone else. Daniel Cameron is the Republican nominee, or someone else that stands for what you believe in. Don't just take their word for it. We've said that before. So these are the kind of things, they matter, because these kind of battles happen. Before we jump into the battle raging further, you mentioned the word wildfire, and I do want to remind folks to continue to be praying for those in Lahaina, Maui, Hawaii. That's an incredibly bad situation, 114 at the last count I heard, and still over 1,000 missing.
Yeah,
that's not good, and that's and there's all kinds of thoughts out there on that, David.
And I'll just since you brought it up, I've had the privilege of getting to visit Maui before and have been to Lahaina. And so it's just been, you know, when you visited a place and you see pictures and I have memories of what it looked like, it's just, it really is devastating.
Yes.
So continue to lift them up in prayer and pray that the church is, and I'm hearing reports, seeing reports of the, you know, unbelievable ministry that local churches and the body of Christ is doing. And, you know, it's, in these moments, sometimes it's opportunities the Lord has provided to minister to people in a true time of need, and it certainly is right now.
Thanks to our listeners for praying for that. I know many are, and if you can help in any way, there's plenty of opportunities out there to do that. My wife and I actually got to honeymoon in Hawaii, so that beauty when it's turned to ashes is really a contrast, as you said. But one of these days, it'll be back, thanks to churches and others who help. Battle raging. I know I saw this, and you've looked at it since then, David. New Jersey had a judge that ruled against these common sense, wise laws. Share a little bit about that.
Well, we're continuing to see, you know, not just in the context of protecting kids on the medical side, but also protecting and empowering parents as it relates to what's going on in schools. And this battle just continues to be raging. And my understanding, Greg, in New Jersey, is some local school districts were simply just trying to ensure that if a child, a parent's child, let's remind ourselves, mom and dad, presumably, of these parents, simply wanted to be informed if their child was, quote-unquote, identifying opposite of their biological sex. And there's been what looks like an activist judge that has said a local school district can't have that kind of policy.
Three of them, actually.
Right.
Three major ones in New
Jersey. So, you know, we passed one of the other provisions, as you alluded to, Greg, in SB 150, provide those protections in state law. But this continues to be a battleground across the nation, particularly in public schools, where unfortunately we're continuing to see those that want to keep parents in the dark about the most important and intimate parts of their own child's lives.
Well, and here's the social outfall of that. It truly is a social health issue, because the government, and now through the schools, which they are public schools, government-run schools, basically, they want to say, they're your kids, but we take them and do what we want and allow them to do whatever they want, and then you parents have to take care of that financially and emotionally and everything else. That's just not right.
Right.
We need to put it where God intended it, as Moses told the leaders in Deuteronomy. This begins and ends with you, parents. And so that's why we stand for that. And thank you, listeners, for praying and supporting for that. We got a couple of really good things going on here. We want to continue to keep those same lines of prayer for Jefferson County and Fayette County, who continues to kind of buck against that as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
So help those parents and help them to see the light there. A couple of good things here as we kind of close round out here today. You got a great story out of Washington State that has been going on for a while. Update us on Coach
Kennedy. Yeah, folks probably have hopefully heard of Coach.
May have forgotten
Joseph Kennedy, and probably prayed for him. But, you know, Coach Kennedy is the one who, it's now been 8 years ago, was fired for simply praying on a football field in Washington State.
Voluntary prayer.
Right.
If you want to join me.
And so challenged that, was defended by our good friends at First Liberty Institute and Kelly Shackelford. That case went all the way up to the U.S. Supreme Court and was decided in his favor last year. Really was a monumental decision for religious freedom. Yes. And in fact, Greg, we passed a law here, Representative Fugit, worked on a law this session that became law that builds on that to provide some protections for school officials, coaches, and so forth as it relates to praying here in Kentucky. But anyways, he now, one of the things, and I've been blessed to be able to speak with, meet with Coach Kennedy a few times, and he has a heart for the Lord. He has a heart for football and loving
kids. Yes.
And he has always wanted to get back on the coaching field at the school that he was fired from. Yeah. And so this whole thing has come full circle now. Not only has he won this religious liberty victory for folks across the nation, he now is back coaching at the school that he was originally let go from. And so I know our friends at First Liberty are encouraging folks on coming up on September 1st is Friday Night Lights and the football games are starting.
Likely
to just
their first
game. Take that opportunity to pray at your football game. Pray for Coach Kennedy, just in thankfulness for how one man's commitment to stand for religious freedom and to honor the Lord has impacted an entire nation.
Courage.
But, you know, just to be in prayer and to remind ourselves of the tremendous freedoms we still have in this country to exercise our faith at a football game and anywhere else.
And if you can go, I think, First Liberty and see a video of him explaining this.
Yeah.
He's saying, you can pray and have silence however you want,
right,
but please take advantage of this
exercise your freedom.
Exercise this freedom, because it is. And as we know, and as our founders knew, and they weren't perfect by any stretch,
right,
as none of our, but they knew these were God-given rights and freedoms,
right,
not government-given.
Right.
And they're taken away.
Our
That's
first
huge.
That's
the very
there
first
was, it was not by accident that religious freedom was recognized as our first freedom, because it's foundational to every other freedom.
Yeah, very good. Anything else as we close out, David?
Well, you know, it's just it was exciting to be able to share some encouraging updates this week. And folks can continue to go to KentuckyFamily.org and sign up and learn more about our upcoming family forum, Family Forum on Saturday.
Good things happening
October
with that.
7th.
They can. You know,
I'm just really excited about how the Lord's bringing together the different speakers and panels and topics that we're going to be covering, and pray that it honors the Lord in a mighty way.
Yes. Amen. Well, David, thank you again for joining us. Another good Family Foundation Friday. And thank you, listeners, for joining in. And invite others to do so. Let them know what's going on, not only on Fridays, but each day with Love and Lordship. We have the Authority of Love broadcast. By the way, if you'd like that book, you can go to loveandlordship.com. I have the second edition, an icon right there in the middle of the homepage. You can click on that. You can get the paperback or the Kindle version. But if you would like to donate, you can always do that. We don't say much about that, but at KentuckyFamily.org or at loveandlordship.com, all of those are fully tax deductible. And so we thank you for that. But more than anything, we thank you for your prayers. Thank you for joining us. Thanks for those prayers. Thanks to the Lord always. And join us again next week. Monday, we'll start out with another Authority of Love. Right now, stay tuned for Bill Reeser and Encounter. And at 12:45, Greg Horn and Hope is here. I'm Greg Williams, and you're listening to the Authority of Love.